Dr. Dotson, for having me come out. It's been so much fun, and we've had a great time. We're going to start my portion of this with a tune called Shanties by Robert Shelton.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. My name is J.J. Wallace. It is my honor and privilege and pleasure to be working with these fine, outstanding orchestra students this week. This first piece that you heard was Brandenburg Concerto No. 5 by Bach. And our next one you're going to hear is one of my favorite pieces. We're going to slow things down a little bit, and we hope you enjoy She Will Hang the Night with Stars.
Thank you.
Andante Festivo by the illustrious Dr. Dodson, y'all. I would like to say thank you so much. I had an absolute blast here. I hope you guys had as much fun as I did. It was a really good time. We had a good time together. Big thank you and shout out to the staff here at Bethany. Everything was so well organized and put together, planned out, and true professionalism. Really appreciate everything you did. We had a great staff of private instructors that worked with all the instrumentalists. I taught like none of the notes. They worked with them one-on-one in small groups. So shout out to those people. Thank you very much. Parents, thank you for bringing your students here. Thank you for trusting us with all of your students and getting them out of the house for a weekend in the summer. Bethany students, past, future, present, all that. Thank you guys for being the counselors. That really made the camp run smooth. And then the final group I want to say is this was so easy for me to do because these kids already came in playing great. And I think that has a lot to do with their school music teachers at home and your private teachers. So when you go home, thank them. Several of them are here. If you have a student that is on stage or has already played or is about to play, would you guys stand up so we can recognize you if you're a private teacher or a school teacher? Telltale heart, in which case, you know, there's a heart and he buries it in the floor and, you know, starts feeling guilty, he thinks he hears it. Anyway, it's a very popular piece of work, and this is based on that. It's kind of cool, it's a little dark, a little foreboding, we hope we don't scare anybody away, but if you listen closely, you're going to hear the sound of the heartbeat. And as we go through the piece, it gets a little bit more and more intense. So we hope you enjoy the Telltale Heart.
Thank you.
y'all, I'm going to get through my really long list of thank yous, or thank yous now, so that way later on when you're ready to leave, you don't have to listen to all my thank yous. So first, this camp would not have happened if it weren't for three people. So a huge thank you to Amanda Deegan, who handled all of A, making the schedule, B, making the flow of the orchestra work. Jacob Andres, who did the same thing on the band side of things, helped make all of that work. And then Jeannie Lucas, who I just saw somewhere, who handled all of the camp operations leading up, leading into the camp. So could I have a huge round of applause for the three of them? Could I have a huge thank you to all of the teachers that were conducting at this camp, teaching applied lessons at this camp, doing all of those other things at this camp, please. And the world's most thankless job, could I have a huge round of applause for all of the counselors and RAs who taught, who were here. It's my pleasure to introduce the final group this afternoon. This is High School Orchestra 1, conducted by Amy Fear, who's director of orchestras at Blue Valley High School in Kansas City. All right, perfect. Y'all, I'm gonna let them tune, and then their first piece is unconducted. We hope you enjoy it.
I'm Jordan, and we will be playing in Vierno. This piece is based off of Winter from Vivaldi's Four Seasons, written in 1721. It depicts someone shivering in the cold, stamping their feet to keep warm, as a blizzard bellows through. I like the dynamic contrast and how it forms the picture of a winter storm in your head. Please enjoy.
Thank you. Hello, I'm Eli Eichhoff. Our next piece is the Waltz from the Masquerade Suite, written by Aram Khachaturian, a Soviet-Armenian composer and conductor. He's considered one of the leading conductors during the Soviet Union's time. The famous Waltz theme in particular gave him a hard time when he was writing it, but he decided to follow inspiration from words from the play. How beautiful the new waltz is, something between sorrow and joy grit my heart. The ballet follows a tragic tale of a bracelet lost in a masked dance, which leads to the main character wrongly accusing his wife of infidelity. Later, the Masquerade premiered on June 21st in 1941 in Moscow. On the following day, Germany invaded the Soviet Union, and its production run was cut short. We hope you enjoy our piece and understand some of its significance and cultural background.
Thank you. My name's Avery. So the next piece we're going to be playing is called Basso Rojo. It's composed by Bert Ligon, who is a director of jazz studies at the University of South Carolina with degrees in jazz performance and piano. So the name comes from two things. One, bossa, the style of bossa nova, and two, rojo, red in Spanish. Bossa nova is the relaxed style of samba that was created in the late 1950s, early 1960s in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. So the score literally says that this is the quote-unquote red-hot party time, and it features four soloists, Roni Castro on cello, Laura Ward on first violin, Eli Aykoff on viola, Nolan Stokes on second violin, and Justin Woolley on percussion. Thank you and enjoy.
Thank you. It has been a wonderful week working with these students, and to work at such a high level, people start throwing out the T word, talent. And they have to obviously have it to be up here. But this group, the reason that they're performing so well today is they work hard and they work smart. And these students have been focused and productive, open to new ideas, both from their clinicians and coming from themselves. And we have worked together very well this week, I think, toward our common goal of growing together as musicians. And thank you for your support of them, and thank you for what you all have taught me this week. Thank you. So this is Basso Rojo.
Thank you. Russian Sailor's Dance by Reinhold Gleer. He was a romantic period Russian composer and violinist born in 1875. This is his best known piece, and it's from a ballet created in 1927. The ballet takes place in China, in a seaport in 1920s-era China. It's a romance between the Soviet sea captain and a Chinese woman, and an uprising on one of the ships. The ballet features sailors from all over the world, but this is the dance of the Russian sailors. And this particular song is based on a Russian folk song, and that's the theme you'll hear throughout this whole piece, over changing backgrounds and different tempos and styles. This is a full orchestra piece, so we have the string section that you just heard, and then in the back there's a bunch of winds and brass and percussion instruments that are going to join us.
much for coming out today. I do have one. Aubrey, are you somewhere? Oh.
Okay, I'm just gonna make a few housekeeping announcements. Students, before you leave today, you need to go back to New Hall, the dorm you've been staying in, to turn in any keys that you still have with you and to check in with the RAs and counselors